गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव डन द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ पैरेलल लाइंस इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो सो आई होप यू रिमेंबर एंड यू हैव सीन द वीडियोज वी हैव डन कॉरिस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स थ्योरम एंड इट्स प्रूफ ऑल्टरनेट एंगल्स थ्योरम एंड इंटीरियर एंगल्स थ्योरम टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ दीज प्रॉपर्टीज And we will complete practice set 2.1. Okay? So, students, I hope you remember that between two parallel lines and one transversal, there are 8 angles formed and they can be classified as interior angles, interior alternate angles and corresponding angles. Corresponding angles between two parallel lines and its transversal are congruent. Similarly, alternate angles are also congruent and interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Okay, so these three properties we have done already in the previous video. Now let's see the application of these theorems in practice set 2.1. So students, you can see the first term in figure, line RP is parallel to line MS and line DK is their transversal. You can see the figure. RP is parallel to MS and DK is a transversal. Okay. Angle DHP is given as 85 degrees. Find the measure of following angles. So there are four angles that is to be found. Angle RHD, that is this one. Okay. Angle PHG, this one. Okay. Angle HGS. Okay, and angle MGK. Okay, so let's see how to find these four angles. Okay, so we'll start the solution for first one. Okay, so always we start with what is given to us, isn't it? So the given data to us is angle DHP equals to 85 degrees. So reason for it is given to us. Okay, now let's correlate this angle with the angle RHD. What is the relation between these two angles? If you remember, we have discussed this in the previous video. These two angles are called as linear pair because their vertices are common and they are forming opposite rays. That means the same line. Okay, so these are called as linear pair of angles. So we will write this property over here. Angle DHP plus angle RHD equals to 180 degrees. Okay. And we have to write the property. What is the reason? Angles in linear pair. Is it clear? Now, we already know what is DHP. Let's substitute this angle here. 85 plus angle RHD is 180 degree. So angle RHD is equal to 180 minus 85 because this 85 we will take here. And if you subtract this, you will get 95 degrees. Okay. So this is our first answer. Measure of angle RHD is 95 degrees. Now let's move ahead to the second one. Second angle is angle PHG. This is a question to us, right? Now, if you look at angle PHG, this is vertically opposite to RSD, okay, which we have already found. So I'll write here angle PHG is congruent to angle RHD. So you have to write the reason for it. Vertically opposite angles. Okay. So vertically opposite angles are always congruent. So it's very clear now. Angle PHG is going to be equal to angle RHD. Their measures are equal. So angle PHG equals to 95 degrees, isn't it? because they both are congruent. So we have already found RHD as 95, therefore PHD is also 95 degrees. Okay. Now let's see the third one. Third one is to find angle HGS, isn't it? Now if you look at HGS, how it is related with the given angle over here, DHP and HGS, they are corresponding angles, isn't it? And we already know that corresponding angles are congruent. So we have to write here reason that line RP is parallel to line MS. From where we got this data? This is given to us in the question. So we'll write here given. Okay. Then I have to write here on transversal line DK. So transversal is line DK. Angle DHP is congruent to angle HGS. Again, reason I have to write here. So reason, we have just mentioned that it is corresponding angles. So corresponding angles are congruent when the lines are parallel, isn't it? So it is congruent only when lines are parallel. So it is already given to us, right? So if DHP is congruent to HGS, that means their measures are equal, isn't it? So I can write here angle DHP is equal to angle HGS. Congruent means their measures are equal. And DHP is already known to us. It is 85 degrees. So angle HGS is also going to be 85 degrees. This is our third answer. I hope it is clear. Now let's see the fourth one. Fourth question of the first part. Here question is find angle MGK. Angle MGK. Okay. Again we will use property because lines are parallel. So angle DHP is congruent to angle MGK. MGK. Okay. This is called as alternate exterior angles. Okay. Alternate exterior angles. So if it is congruent, then obviously their measures are equal. Okay. So I can write here angle MGK is equal to 85 degrees. Why? Because DHP is already given to me 85 degrees. So therefore MGK is also 85 degrees. Right? If you want, you can mention here reason. Because angle DHP is equal to 85 degrees. Okay? So you can see that we have found all four questions. Okay.